So let us discuss the instrumentation of IR spectrophotometer, FTIR spectrophotometer. So now it is known to us that there are two types of the system use, dispersive and FTIR. The instrumentation basic design, the main differences, these are in light source as well as the detector one. In normal IR instrument, similar to UV visible spectrophotometer, but in the FTIR, the main difference is light source and detector system. So light source must produce the IR radiations, cannot use the glass because it shows the absorption. So sodium chloride plates are used as an sample holder or plates. So mostly the Nernst blower is used as a light source. This Nernst blower lamp is a rare earth metal oxide. It is a metal oxides of zirconium, selenium or thorium. These are heated electrically. So apply current to cylinder as a resistance to current flow generates the heat up to 1200 to 2200 degrees Celsius. So these are the metal oxides. If these are get heated externally, electrically, it generates the heat or say the radiations and causes the light production similar to the black body radiations in the range of 670 to 10,000 per centimeter wave number. It needs good current control or overheaters. Then second lamp, that is the Nernst blower. It is similar to the Nernst blower, but uses here is the use of silicon carbide rod instead of the metal oxides heated electrically and then it produces the particular radiations. Here in Nernst blower, there is use of silicon carbide rod instead of the earth oxides and it produces the range similar to the Nernst blower. Another lamp radiation source use is a incandescent wire source. These are the tightly wound nichrome. This is the nichrome or rhodium wire. This is the tightly bound nichrome or rhodium wire that is electrically heated. Same principle as the Nernst blower. Only the difference is in the material use. Material use as a source. Same principle as Nernst blower and Nernst blower. But the lower intensity than the previous two radiation sources. Then CO2 laser used as a radiation source in IR spectrophotometer. It is a mixture of 70% helium, 15% carbon dioxide and 15% nitrogen. A voltage is placed across the gas which excites the nitrogen to the lowest vibrational levels. So the excited nitrogen populates the asymmetric vibrational states in the carbon dioxide through the collisions. So this is the mechanism how the different types of the gases or the metals are used and they get heated or electrically high voltage is applied and how it emits the radiation. So this is the simple mechanism. So there may be question that various radiation sources used in UV or in IR. So short note. Or what type of the radiation sources are used, etc., etc. How much the intensity of the radiations is generated by each particular lamp, there may be questions. So other lamps use mercury arc, tungsten lamp, and the detector system. So two main types of commonly used detectors in IR instrumentation, thermal detectors, thermocouple, the name, the word is there, thermocouple means the two pieces of dissimilar metals. See in the diagram, metal 1 and metal 2. There are two pieces of dissimilar metal. Metal 1 is different than metal 2. These are fused together at their ends. They are connected together at their ends. When heated, metals heat at different rates. Obviously, if we heat the two metals, the heating rate or the heating difference is there. So this creates the potential difference in between the two metals, and that varies with their difference in the temperature. So usually made with the blackened surface just to improve the heat absorption. So place in an evacuated tube. So two dissimilar metals, metal 1 and metal 2, these are connected at their end, they are fused at their end, and they are placed in an evacuated tube with the windows which are transparent to IR. And these windows are not of glass or quartz, because glass, even the quartz material, will show the absorption, IR absorptions. So IR heats and heat one of the two wires. Can use several thermocouples to increase the sensitivity. So here, thermal detectors, example is thermocouple, which works on the change in their thermal conductivity. That's why these detectors are known as the thermal detectors. So two dissimilar metals fused together, placed in an evacuated glass tube, it is not the glass tube, and along with the windows, which are transparent to the IR radiations. This is known as the thermocouple detector. Then bolometer. In bolometer type of detector, a strips of metal, generally platinum and nickel, strips of metal or semiconductor that has a large change in resistance to current with temperature. So as light is absorbed by the blackened surface, resistance increases and current decreases. So very sensitive. So based on the same principle, the bolometer works. Next one is the photoconducting detectors. Photoconducting, a thin film of semiconductor on a non-conducting glass surface and sealed in a vacuum. See, semiconductors on a glass surface, non-conducting glass surface, and sealed in a vacuum tube. Absorption of light by semiconductor moves from non-conducting to conducting states. So decrease in resistance, increase in current. So the range generates 10,000 to 333 per centimeter wave number at the room temperature. So remember the construction and working, and how much the radiations are detected, what intensity or frequency the radiations are detected by the individual detector is important. Pyroelectric detectors. So it is made up with the ceramic, lithium tantalate. So polyelectric material get polarized, that is separation, positive and negative charge in presence of electric field. So temperature dependent polarization. So measures the degree of polarization related to the temperature of crystal. So shows very fast response and good FTIR, good for FTIR. So based on the material, based on the different principle, the different types of the detector systems are used. So sample cell must be transparent to IR radiations. So generally KBR pellets or sodium chloride pellets, you can see in a diagram, these are very transparent. Even though if you see the sodium chloride or potassium bromide through the naked eyes, these are non-transparent material. But if the technique is so that they prepared, or we can prepare, the industry can prepare the sodium chloride plates transparently. Then monochromators, as usual, the different monochromators system used just to convert the wavelength into a monochromatic radiations. So FTIR, this is the alternative to IR. It splits the light source with the help of the mirror into two beams of equal intensity. One is for reference, another one is for sample. So interferogram is used here. Already we discussed interferogram, but the basic theory, what we mean by the interference. So again, constructive and destructive interference. And based on the same, the interferogram is designed. So first diagram is interferograms, which converts the signal, where the second is the dispersive phenomenon. So advantage of FTIR compared to IR, much faster use signal, averaging to increase the signal noise. No slits required, less optical requirement, high resolution. And lastly, the applications of IR spectroscopy or IR spectrophotometer. They are very important. Identification of functional groups and structure elucidation of organic compounds. Applications of IR spectroscopy. Mainly, IR spectroscopy is useful for qualitative as well as quantitative analysis. So in qualitative analysis, identification of the different functional groups and their structure elucidation parts. Quantitative analysis of number of organic compounds. Study of covalent bonds in molecules. Study of covalent bonds. Whether the presence of covalent bonding, strong bond is there or weak bond is there. Studying the progress of reaction. Again, this is very important. Study the progress of reaction A plus B, whether there is a formation of the product C or not. We can check it by even UV and IR. If there is change in functional group, we can say that yes. Or if there is a formation of the new functional group, we can say that yes, there is a reaction takes place. Detection of impurities in a compound, just by observing the IR band on the graph, you can see that other functional groups are also present. It means that there is a presence of an impurity, or even you can compare the IR band of impurity with the sample graph. Ratio of cis and trans isomers in a mixture. We can easily identify the whether the presence of the cis and trans isomers in a mixture. Study of the presence of water in a sample, moisture, hydroxyl group, shape of symmetry of inorganic molecules, symmetrical or asymmetrical. Again, there is change in their absorption frequency, vibrational frequency. The same changes are noted, observed on the IR band or graph. Measurement of paints and varnishes, the same thing, qualitative analysis. What are the limitations of IR spectroscopy? Cannot determine the molecular weight of the compound. IR spectroscopy is not helpful for determination of molecular weight. So for determination of molecular weight, we need to go by mass spectroscopy. Does not give information about the relative position of